ಅನುದಿನಾ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hello, good morning students. I am Srimati Vijayalakshmi, Government Urdu High School, Station Bazar, Yadagiri. Welcome students to e-classes, Samveda e-classes. Third language, English, 9th standard. Now today we are going to deal with the lesson number 2. Already you have learned the first lesson. Today we are going to learn the lesson number 2, a great king who yoked the plow. Now pre-reading activity, students, in history you have read about many great kings. They have treated their subjects as their own children. They were kind and just to the subjects. They have encouraged and helped them in times of need. So, always being just and kind is a very good quality, children. And even you have to develop such qualities. You will be inspired when you learn about the great kings, about their stories. So today, let's start the lesson with a small activity. Now here, students, you can see the pictures of the great kings. Now identify the great kings shown in the picture. Yes, I'll give you 1 minute time. All of you listen carefully. And identify the king. Yes, very good. You have identified the king. Yes, who is that? What's the name of the king? He is Akbar. Yes, very good, students. You have given the right answer. Very good. He is Akbar. Akbar was third Mughal emperor. Akbar's reign significantly influenced the course of Indian history. Okay, students, now you can see another picture, all of you. Listen carefully, observe the picture. And who is the king? Yes, you are very eager, you are very keen to give the answers. Okay, yes, very good. You have given the right answer, very good. He is Ashoka. Yes, you have identified correctly. Very good, children. Now, let's know something about Ashoka. Ashoka the Great was an Indian emperor of the Maurya dynasty. Ashoka's own inscriptions are the earliest self-representations of an imperial power in the Indian subcontinent. Okay, children, see here, you came to know about Ashoka, the great king. Yes, he was an Indian emperor of the Maurya dynasty. Very good. Now let's move on to the next picture. Okay, students, now see the next picture. Yes, observe carefully, all of you. Yes, I'll give you little time. Yes, you have seen the picture. Yes, who is the king? Can you mention his name? Yes, very good. What is his name? He is Chandragupta. Oh, so nice. You have observed very correctly. Excellent, students. Now let's know about Chandragupta. You have studied about him in the history, isn't it? Yes. Chandragupta Maurya was the founder of the Maurya Empire in ancient India. He was taught and counseled by the philosopher Chanakya. Yes, students, Chandragupta Maurya was the founder of the Maurya Empire in ancient India. Yes, ancient means old. Modern is new. You know very well, isn't it? Okay. Now, see here, we are going to learn about a small story of a king shown in the picture. Yes, all of you see the picture. All of you be ready with pencils or pen and the textbook. Listen carefully because listening is very, very important. Unless you listen the language, you cannot speak. Isn't it? Very good students, English is a rich language, is a beautiful language. You are eager to learn the language. So be ready and listen to the story now. Yes. Now we are going to learn about a small story of a king shown in the picture. You will be very eager to know who is there in the picture, isn't it? What is his name? He is Raja Bhoj. Yes, the king is Raja Bhoj. Very good. Now, see, Raja Bhoj was a great king who ruled over Malwa, part of the present day Madhya Pradesh. You can see the picture of Madhya Pradesh, students. Okay? Yes, in the part of present day Madhya Pradesh. So, who was Raja Bhoj? Raja Bhoj was a great king. Where did he rule? He ruled over Malwa, part of the present day Madhya Pradesh. So, you can identify Raja Bhoj now, isn't it? Yeah. So, what is the speciality of this king? What is the quality of this king? So, let's learn about this king in the class now. Okay. See here, Raja Bhoj was a just and kind king and always very attentive to the problems of the subjects. Raja Bhoj was a just and kind king. Students, always you must learn to be just and kind to others. This is a very good quality. As students, if you develop such good qualities, it will be very helpful for you in the life and you can become very great, good citizens of the nation. So, Raja Bhoj was a just and kind king and always very attentive to the problems of the subjects. Do you know, children? He was very attentive. Why was he attentive? He wanted to attend to the problems of the subjects. Who are the subjects here? Subjects means people. Yes, the people living in his kingdom. They are called as the subjects. Not English, mathematics, science, social, not those subjects. Here, subjects means people of the kingdom. Yes, Raja Bhoj, he was very attentive to the problems of the subjects. He was a very kind king. He was a very just king, students. Now, let's see about him. Now, yes, what did he do? He used to disguise himself and move around his kingdom. He used to disguise himself and move around his kingdom, trying to understand the real situations and took steps to improve the conditions. Okay, students? Now, what do you mean by disguise? Disguise means changing the appearance of. Means the king used to disguise himself. He used to change himself. He never used to be in the royal clothes, but he used to wear ordinary man's common clothes and used to, yes, go and attend to the problems of the citizens, that is the people. Now, see now. On one such trip, the king came across a farmer who was plowing his field, but with a difference. On one such trip, the king came across a farmer who was plowing the field, but with a great difference. Okay. See here, all of you might have seen the farmers plowing the field. What's the difference here? What was the difference? Let's see here. Instead of the two bulls, he yoked a bull to one side and his wife to the other. See, students, all of you listen carefully to the picture. Yes. What happened here? Instead of two bulls, he yoked his wife to the next. Instead of two bulls, he yoked a bull to one side and his wife to the other. See here, students, this is an exclamatory sentence, that is an exclamation mark. This is a very rare thing. You cannot see this because instead of two bulls, He, who is he here? The farmer yoked a bull to one side and his wife to the other. See, you can see in the picture, what is that? A farmer is ploughing his field and bull on the one side and his wife on the other side. You can see a tree there. The king Raja Bhoj is standing there in the ordinary clothes and he is just seeing what is going on. Okay, students, can you see the picture? All of you, observe carefully. Very good. The bull and his wife were ploughing the bull and his wife were pulling the plough with great difficulty, and the king was sad seeing their plight. What happened, students? The bull and his wife were pulling the plough. Yes, with great difficulty. It's very hard. In the place of the bull, his farmer's wife was pulling the plough with a great difficulty. So the king was sad seeing their plight. See there, you can see, identify the farmer's wife. Now, new words from these slides. Disguise. Okay, students, now listen carefully. Here is the picture of a person who has disguised himself. Disguise means change the appearance of. Disguise means change the appearance of. Okay, students, now let's see the next word, that is plow. Yes, all of you can see the plow. Have you seen this? Yes, because our India is the country of that is villages. You could have seen everywhere farmers plowing the field. So now you can see the instrument for tilling the land. Plow is nothing but the instrument for tilling the land. The next word is yoke. Yes, you can see the yoke in the picture, students. A wooden cross piece fastened over the knees of two oxen pulling a plow. A wooden cross piece fastened over the necks of two oxen pulling a plow. So yoke, all of you observe this. You have seen this, I think. Yes, what is yoke, children? Yoke is nothing but a wooden cross piece fastened over the necks of the two oxen pulling a plow. Okay, students, now listen here. Raja Bhoj, by seeing the plight of the farmer's wife, Raja Bhoj called out to the farmer. Yes, you can see in the picture, Raja Bhoj, he called out to the farmer. Yes, he addressed to the farmer. He speaks to the farmer like this. My dear man, what are you doing? Can you not see that your wife is suffering? Yes, yoked as she is with the bull. How can you treat her thus? So, like this, the Raja Bhoj asked to the farmer. The man, who obviously could not recognize the king in his disguise, continued his work. See, when the king was asking the question, the farmer could not recognize the king in his disguise, because the king was in his disguise. He couldn't recognize the king, and he started continuing the work. Then he replied. What did he reply, the farmer? See. I do not have time to stop and explain things to you, but in any case, she is my wife and this is our farm. What I do is no concern of yours. Okay, see here, once again, the farmer is replying like this. I do not have time to stop my work. Yes, because I have got a lot of things to do, he explained. But in any case, she is my wife and It is no concern of yours. He said like this. Who? The farmer. The king would not give up so easily and went along with the man, asking for an explanation. At last, the man said, yes, the king would not give up so easily. Easy, what's the opposite for the word easy? Hard, you know all of you, because we'll be writing the examinations, okay. Here, the king also would not give up easily. Means, what did he do? Till the farmer gave the answer, the king did not give up and went along with the man. Here, who is the man? The farmer is the man. So, what did the king wanted? He wanted an explanation from the king. So, he was asking for an explanation. At last, the man said, yes. The man said, who is that man? The farmer. He said, I had two bulls, but one died recently and I have no money to buy another. If I do not plow the field now, I shall not be able to grow anything on my yes, and I shall not be able to grow anything, and we shall have to starve this year. Yes, like this the farmer told. I had no choice but yoke my wife to the plow. I would have yoked myself, but she cannot handle the plow by herself. What else can I do? Like this the king. The farmer, he said, okay. Now the farmer, he told his condition. What was his condition? The farmer couldn't do anything because there was no choice left for him. Because if he stopped the work, what would happen? He would have to starve because the rain might arrive and before sowing the seeds, if the rain arrives and if there are no seeds sown, what will happen? He won't be having any harvest and so he would have to starve. So that's why he could have yoked his wife, but his wife couldn't handle the plow. That is why he explained. Who? The farmer. He explained like this to the king. The king was filled with pity and said, by listening to the farmer, the king was filled with pity and said, what did he say? My dear man, please come along with me and I shall give you a bull. You do not have to pay any money. See here, the king is helping the farmer like this by telling like this. What is he saying? My dear man, please come along with me and I shall give you a bull. You do not have to pay any money. So the king wants to help the farmer, isn't it? So he is ready to give the farmer a bull without any money. Okay, students, have you understood? Okay. Now let's see. The man replied for this. What did the farmer say? What did the farmer say? What did he reply? Let's see. So the man replied like this. What did he say? If I leave my work now, the rains might arrive. See here. If I leave my work now, the rains might arrive before I plant the seeds. I cannot come with you. If you really want to help me, bring the bull here. See here. The farmer, he did not recognize the king because the king was in disguise. The farmer thought the king was an ordinary man. And he said like this. What did he say? If I leave my work now, the rains might arrive. Arrive. What do you mean by arrive? Arrive means come. You know the meaning, isn't it, children? Yes. The train arrives on the platform at 5 p.m. Means here, arise means coming. Depart. What do you mean by depart? Depart means, yes, going, isn't it? Departure from that place, leaving that place. That is called as depart. And those, both the words are antonyms. Arrive, depart. See here, if I leave my work now, the rains might arrive before I plant the seeds. I cannot stop the work now, he said, because if I stop my work now, the rains might arrive and before I plant the seeds, what will happen? I cannot come with you. if you really want to help me, bring the bull here. He ordered like this. Who? The farmer. The king did not want to leave while the woman was still yoked the plow. He was a righteous king and could not bear to see such pains. So he said, yes, the king did not want to leave while the woman was still yoked to the plow, because the woman is suffering. The king has seen the woman is suffering. She is yoked and she is suffering. So he did not want to leave there. What did he do? He was a righteous king. He wanted to help the farmer's wife in any condition. He was not ready to leave her, the king, and could not bear to see such pain. The king was a very kind-hearted person. He couldn't tolerate and he couldn't see anybody suffering. So such a good king he was. Okay, students? And as students, see, even you people, you should help others. When somebody is suffering, you have to help them. How much is possible, that much you have to help the others. That's a very good quality, children. You have to develop it. Now what happens, see here. Let your wife go along with my men to my wife and collect the bull. Meanwhile, I shall take her place and plow your field. See here, the king is telling like this now. Because the farmer is anyway, he is not ready. He is asking the king itself to bring the king himself to bring the bull here. So the king thought like this and said, let your wife go along with my men to my wife and collect the bull. Meanwhile, I shall take her place and plow your field. See now, students, have you understood? The king is ready to take the place of the farmer's wife and plow the field. Okay, children, next what will happen? See here. The farmer had no answer to this and he agreed accordingly. He unyoked his wife and yoked the king to the plow and continued his work. Okay, children, now the farmer did not have any choice because the king was ready to take the place of the farmer's wife. He himself was ready to yoke and he wanted to leave the farmer's wife, and he is sending the farmer's wife to his palace, that is to meet the queen and bring the bulls there. Accordingly, now the farmer had no choice, so he unyoked. What do you mean by unyoked, children? Unyoked means, that is releasing, means freeing from the yoke, isn't it? He unyoked, that's the antonym, that is a prefix form there. Unyoked his wife and yoked the king. Yoke, unyoke, okay. The king to the plow and continued his work. Students, let's continue the story in the next session. This is a very interesting story, isn't it, students? Yes. Okay. Now next, we will continue this in the next session. We will have some fun with activities now. You're all interested to do the activities, isn't it, children? Okay. Now we'll have some fun with the activities. Now let's see some more new words. Plight. Now here, plight. What is this plight? Plight means it is condition. Plight is nothing but the condition. You can see the farmer's wife is suffering. She is in a bad condition. Means instead of the bull, she is yoked to the plow. This is called plight. It is condition, children. Did you understand this new word today? Yes, very good. Daily you have to learn some few new words, students. After going home, you have to read the lesson. You have to understand the new words. You have to write them. And you have that, as you learn to learn the new words, your vocabulary will be improved and your English language will also be improved. Okay, and also you will remember very much. So listen carefully and understand. See here, the above picture shows the condition of the farmer and his wife. Observe carefully, students. Here you can see the farmer and his wife and their condition. So what's the new word you have learnt there? It's nothing but plight. Now the next word, that is star. What is it? Star. Yes, what is the meaning of this star? Star means suffer from lack of food. When we don't have food, we have to suffer. isn't it, suffer from lack of food. See students, all of you can see the picture. The above picture shows how farmer is suffering from the lack of food due to the failure of crops. See, when will the crops fail? When there is no rain, what will happen? There will be failure of crops. When there is failure of crops, what will happen? You have to suffer from the lack of food. When the farmers doesn't grow any crops, there will be no food for us, isn't it? So suffer, that is star means, what is the meaning of star? Suffer from lack of food. So this is another new word, students. You have learned today, star. Star is nothing but suffering from lack of food. I think you have understood. Now, here is another word. What is this word? Righteous. Yes, righteous. Here, see here, you can see in the picture, he is righteous, isn't it? The word describes quality of a person. See here, the king Raja Bhoj was a righteous person. He was an honest person. Righteous means nothing but honest. So here the word describes the quality of a person. All these words describe the quality of the persons, righteous and honest. Even you people, always you must be righteous students and you must be honest students. You have to develop virtuous qualities with you, students. See, from learning these stories, you have to learn some of the values also. Even as children, you should be honest. You should not tell lies. You should obey your parents. You should obey your elders. Okay, students? Enough. Now, righteous, you have understood. Okay, students, till now you have understood something. Let's check your understanding, what you have understood. Okay, students, now I am going to ask you a few questions. Let me see how you will give the answers. Are you ready? Yes, very good. Now, first question, what made the king sad? Yes, who will give me the answer? Yes, so nice. Come on, you have raised your hand. Yes, what's the answer? The king was sad by seeing the plight of the farmer's wife. Oh, so nice. Excellent answer. Very good. Sit down. So here, what made the king sad? The king was sad by seeing the plight of the farmer's wife. What is the plight here? Condition. Condition of the farmer's wife. So it made the king sad. Very good, students. You have understood the first question and first answer. Now, let's move to the next one. See here, this is the RC question, means reference to context questions. You will have such questions in your examinations. So listen carefully. If you read the lesson properly, if you understand the lesson properly, you will be very easy. It will be very easy for you to give the answers, students. See here, the question is, my dear man, what are you doing? My dear man, what are you doing? Who asked this question? Who asked this question, students? My dear man, what are you doing? Who asked this question? Oh, so nice. All of you have raised your hands. So nice. Yes, come on, give the answer. Yes, very good. Right answer. The king asked this question. Who asked this question? The king asked this question. Now, this is the third question, students. See here. My dear man, what are you doing? Who does dear man refer to? Listen carefully. Who does dear man refer to? The king said, my dear man, what are you doing? Here, who does dear man refer to? I think all of you understood the question. Yes, I can see on your faces. You are eager to give the answers. Very good. Yes, one of you, please give the answer. Yeah, very good. Nice answer. Excellent. Yes, keep it up. Yes, what's the answer? Dear man refers to the farmer. Very good. Yes, all of you clap your hands. Yes, dear man refers to the farmer. Now, let's move on to the next question. My dear man, what are you doing? Why did he ask this question? Why did he ask this question? Yes. Yes. Students, think and give the answer to me. Yes, very good. Yes, right answer. Keep it up. He asked this question because The king was sad by seeing their plight. He asked this question because the king was sad by seeing their plight. Very good students, you have given all the answers correctly. So this shows that you have understood the lesson very well. It's so nice. Now, all of you, listen here. Let's do a small activity. We use certain words to express our feelings. Now, identify the words in the following sentences that express feelings. Do you know, children, what are the feelings? Yes. Now, let me see how you will identify the feelings. Okay, I'll show you some pictures. All of you observe carefully. Okay, students? Yes. See here. The farmer was shocked to know that the man was the king. The farmer was shocked to know that the man was the king. So here, which word shows you the feeling? Yes, it is nothing but the word shocked. Yeah, see here, you can see the picture. Yes, the above picture express the feeling of shock. If something happens, what will happen? You will be shocked, isn't it? Yeah, if somebody is hurt, if somebody gets into an accident, if you know the news suddenly, what will happen? You will be shocked. So this is the feeling. So here the farmer was shocked to know that the man was the king. When the farmer came to know the man was the king, he was shocked because the king was in disguise. So you understood the feeling of the shocked. The above picture expressed the feeling of the shock. Now let's see the second one. He was very happy with the worker. He was very happy with the worker. Oh, see, so many of you are ready to say, yes. Which is the word showing the feeling? Happy. You know, yes, because I can see all your faces are smiling, isn't it? You are very happy, children. Yeah, see here. The picture above shows, that is, that express the feeling of happiness. Can you see that? How happy they are, isn't it? When you are happy, your face itself shows that you are very, very happy. The picture expresses the feeling of happiness, students. Okay. Now, let's move on to the next sentence now. Everyone in the court was surprised. Everyone in the court was surprised. So, surprised is the word which shows the feeling. Okay. See here, the picture, you can identify the surprise, isn't it? Yeah, the picture shows the feeling of surprise. So these are nothing but the words. So far you have seen, they are the feelings. Now the next word, see here. The king was sad for the plight of the farmer. Sad. Even this word expresses the feeling of sadness. You can see here, the picture expresses the feeling of sadness, isn't it, students? Yes, when you are sad, when your friend is sad, you will come to know. When your friend is happy, you will come to know. Like that, all these shocked, sad, all these words, they express the feelings. Lily pitied the old beggar. Next sentence, students. Lily pitied the old beggar. Pitied. Yeah, here also you can see the picture. See how pity. You can see, you can identify that expression there. Yeah, the picture expresses the feeling of pity. Now, students, you have already seen the expressions so far, isn't it? Now, I think you are ready for the home assignment. See, students, you have to find out the opposites for the following words from the puzzle and write them in the space provided. Now, all of you can see the puzzle here. Yes, one example is done for you, students. First one is kind, opposite is cruel. You can see the word cruel there. It is written in the colors, isn't it? Yeah, C-R-U-E-L, cruel. Like that, you have to identify the antonyms for the remaining words. All of you, I think, sure, you will do the homework and come tomorrow, because I will check tomorrow in the next class. Okay, students? Now, are you happy? Have you understood the lesson? Very good. Thank you, students.
ಹಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂ